Let's look at this first line and what it's going to do for us. It's going to create an object that delegates to car.prototype, which is what we're already doing. That means we can get rid of the part where we were doing that ourselves. It also seems to be assigning the result of that object creation to the keyword this. Now, even though you couldn't possibly write this line of code in your own programs, the interpreter is capable of binding values to the keyword this. It kind of makes sense and is in keeping with our understanding of what the keyword this is used for. The intention of the keyword this is to be a convenient way of referring to whatever the target object is in some object-oriented function call. This function call is pretty object-oriented. The intent is that we're going to build a new thing. So it makes a lot of sense that whatever that new thing is could be the target of the keyword this. Now that we have a way of referring to a brand new object that's created to delegate to the car prototype, we might as well get rid of all of these new obj variables that we introduced. We can just instead use the keyword this. Lastly, we can tell that this return statement that will be inserted by the interpreter seems to duplicate what's being done above in the line that we wrote. It's unnecessary to have two return statements, and in fact, the way this code would operate, we should never be able to reach the last line, since the second to last line would already have returned from the function. We can get rid of the return statement that we wrote as well, and just trust that this inserted return statement will do the work we need. We're done refactoring to avoid the duplication between the code we had written and the code that got inserted for us. But remember, this code is just a mental note to remind us what the keyword new does. So let's get rid of those notes because we know they're not actually going to show up anywhere in our program. Let's take away the extra white space so that we can see it written more clearly. This is what we would expect to type when we're making a pseudo-classical class.